So we're talking about pembrolizumab in patients with HIV and cancer.
Yes, released in JAMA Oncology was a paper that is really the first publication of a prospective phase one trial looking at the use of pembrolizumab, an immune checkpoint inhibitor, in patients with HIV. Now, we know that patients with HIV who are living much longer are starting to develop cancers, mm-hmm. not only AIDS-related cancers, but also cancers that everyone else develops. And so in this study, investigators looked at HIV patients and asked, will they respond to immune checkpoint inhibitors mm-hmm. like other patients do, because HIV is a disease of the immune system.
Right.
And HIV patients are categorized into one of three groups: low levels of CD4 T cells, intermediate levels, and high levels. And what these investigators did is, instead of doing a dose escalation on the drug, mm-hmm. they looked at the same dose of drug in different cohorts of patients with very low levels of CD4 T cells or pretty high levels of CD4 T cells. And what they found was really quite interesting. CD4 T cells, it's been reported that patients with HIV have levels of PD-1 on the surface of them, their cells. And pembrolizumab is an anti-PD-1 monoclonal antibody. When they treated the HIV patients, almost all of them had some increase in their CD4 T cells, which is good, although it wasn't significant. And no patients developed HIV viremia. The overall response rate was about 10%.
Mm.
And there were partial responses seen in all different cohorts, no matter what their CD4 T cell count was. And one patient with lung cancer had a complete remission. So the take-home message is, patients with HIV who develop diseases that can be treated by immune checkpoint inhibitors should be treated with immune checkpoint inhibitors, except for patients who have active viremia with KS herpes virus. You might want to use other alternative therapies for them.